Hello friends, welcome back. It's long since we had a session for Python. So we are going to have three successive sessions quickly in maybe next 3 days. And in this session, we are going to learn the complete details on the strings. We are going to expose the string functions. We are going to completely explore strings. We are going to talk about the string indexing, string traversal, string concatenation, appending, repeating, how do you ignore the escape sequences, etc. very clearly in this session, and I hope it is fun. First thing that we are going to start with is traversal of the string. How do you traverse string? Is it possible in Python? Yes, we need to do it and we can do it. It is very simple. But we need to have something called as indexing to be followed for the traversal to be enabled. And we are going to do that right now. We will have index as a reference and then we can navigate. We'll have an example. Let's see this here. So we have it as string traversal right now. Remember, we need to have the indexing, else we are gone. Now, I have a string by name Sachin_Tendulkar and I have got index as 0. Remember this, is called the indexing that I'm talking about. Now, print. I'm just printing it. Here you go, the characters from the string. That's it. Now, for I in string, you can see what is I here. I in string. What is string? String is Sachin_Tendulkar. Print of I. Index equal to index plus 1. What is the index? Index is 0. So what I do here, I am just starting from 0. I increment it by 1 by 1. And then I print each and every character. And how does it work? Can we see the output? It prints very nicely. Sachin_Tendulkar is printed so nicely. And you are getting the output here. So what is indexing? This is called indexing, which helps you to start and then you can navigate from there. The string traversal is simple and this is how you have done it. It's easy and simple. Now, can we go for string concatenation? String cat. Shri plus Ram is equal to Shriram. That's how we work, right? It's very simple. We are going to have some simple example. String_first_off equal to Sachin. String_second_off is equal to Tendulkar. Now, how do I concatenate it? Very simple, use plus operator. That's it. String equal to string_first_off plus string_second_off and you print it as string. Do you get the output? Of course, yes. Here you go. Sachin Tendulkar is the output. That's very simple and effective. Can we go for string appending? Yes, we can do the appending operation as well. String_first equal to Sachin. Now, we have string_append. This is the name of the variable that I have. Print, enter the string to be appended. Now use this string_first plus equal to. This plus is called as the appending operator and this helps you to append this content onto this string. String_first plus equal to. This is very, very important and remember. And this gets appended to it and you print the string first. Can we test the output? Yes, Sachin Tendulkar is the greatest of cricketers. Simple, it has got the output. Now, can we print a string multiple times? Yes, we can do it, but we need to use star for it. How do you use it? String_example equal to Sachin Tendulkar. Print string_example into 4. It is just multiplication here and we get the output 4 times. That's simple and easy to try. Now, can we escape the escape sequences? Means you need to ignore the escape sequences. We can do it and it is easy. Can we try it once? Yes. Now see that print /n Sachin Tendulkar. Print r followed by the same statement whatever I had here including /n. This r will tell the Python that ignore it and the output will be like this. /n will always be present here then. You can see it here. So this r is the character that I'll have to use here to tell Python that ignore the escape sequence. It's important and easy. Can you go to the next one? Yeah. We need to learn the built-in functions. Python is very strong and people prefer Python over any other programming language these days because it has got a lot of inbuilt functions. Can we see some more here? Yes. We are going to see how to use the capitalize function. Capitalize is an inbuilt option available with Python. So I'm using str_demo equal to Shriram. Print str_demo. Capitalize. Similarly, Sachin, Tendulkar, all these three strings with first character not capitalized. It is lowercase letters. And I have used the option strdemo.capitalize here. Can we see the output? Yes, the first letter all will be capitalized and they will be turned on to the uppercase format. Very simple, right? So this is called capitalize. Now, we are going to use the center, C-E-N-T-E-R. It will help you in filling the characters. What do you mean by filling the characters? The animation has got a problem here, I think, in this slide. Anyways, we can handle it. This is the code that you need to understand. Now, see this here. STR underscore demo is equal to Sachin. Print STR underscore demo center 20 star. So I want the Sachin to be printed in the space of 20 characters. And if Sachin is not 20 characters long, I need to fill rest of the characters with star. This is what I mean as center, right? I hope you understood clearly. Now, when you see the output, you can understand it. Sachin, here I have got stars filled. Here I have got stars filled. Sachin is in the center, but it occupies 20 characters length. Very easy, right? I hope you can try it out and you can understand things better here. It's easy, right? We'll go to the next one shortly. Can we count? Yes. Count option is as well available. What is count? It's very simple. It is an inbuilt function. It helps you to count the number of times a particular string appears in a bigger string. And you can start from whichever position you want. If you want to start counting from the first character, that's fine. If you want to start intermediary, that's also fine. Now see it here. I will move on to the laser pointer. Now see Sachin Tendulkar, Sachin Tendulkar, Sachin Tendulkar thrice. I am having the string test as Sachin. I am searching for Sachin. How many number of times Sachin is available here? And see that here, dot count, string demo dot count, test. Test is the string that I am searching for. And I am searching from the first zeroth character, which means the first character, Sachin. From yes, I am searching for. And the entire string length is what I am covering. I am taking the same string now, but I start from the 10th character. So shall we see the output? Yes. First time, 3 times Sachin is available. Second time, only 2 times Sachin is available because I have crossed 10 characters. That's it. Count is very easy and very important too. Right? We'll go to the next one. Can we check if a string ends with a particular set of characters? I have written a string. I need to now see if it ends with a particular set of characters. Is it possible? Yes, we can do it. We have got ends with. Ends with is an inbuilt function that helps you in doing it. So string underscore demo, Sachin Tendulkar, test is kar. I want to see if this string ends with kar. So for that I need to use str underscore demo dot ends with. What is test? Test is nothing but kar. What is zero? Zero says that it should start from here, first character. What is length of str demo? The complete length is what I want to see. Now similarly, I am searching for Sachin Tendulkar with kamb, kamb, and same is the content. Now here it ends with kar, so I should get true. Here it ends with kamb, which is false, so I should get false. Can you see the output? True and false. That's it. It's very simple, right? So this function of ends with is very helpful in understanding if a function, if a string ends with a particular set of characters. It's easy. Can we find now? We are going to find. We are going to find if a string is present in another string. Also, we will understand if the position, we can also understand in which position the string is available. It will return the position. If a string is available, the position will be returned. Otherwise, minus one will be returned. It's very simple. And we are going to see an example. Now see, str underscore demo, Sachin Tendulkar. I am searching for KAR. This is the string that I am talking about. And find is the option. Now, what do we find? We find KAR if it is available. Where do we start finding it from? From zero for the entire string. Similarly, KAMB is also tried out and we are doing the same stuff. Now let's see the output. It's very simple. First time, 13. So you can see that KAR starts with the 13th position. Second one, I did not have anything called as KAMB in the entire string. So it returns minus one, right? It's very easy and simple. Now we are going to use a few more inbuilt functions in this session. It's all easy. Let's just try it out. All fun. All these are for fun. You can try it out in your system whenever you are feeling bored. So first is all number. Sachin Tendulkar 200 not out. STR demo is all number. Now what is it? Very simple. We are going to see if a string has got at least one character. Also, if the string is entirely with character or number, it is okay. If we have at least one character, and if the entire string is filled with character or number, it is okay. It will return true, otherwise it will return false. You see here, str underscore demo is all number. Same thing, I have removed the space out here. Space is also a character, right? So here I have just concatenated everything without space. I use the same function. Can you see the output? First one false because I had space inside, so the function won't work. Second one I had true because I had no space inside, and it is all numbers are characters. Perfect, right? It's all fun. Right. Similarly, we are going to see inbuilt function is alpha. What is is alpha? If it returns true if at least one character is there, and every character should be an alphabet, else it is false. Now you can see it here. Sachin space Tendulkar space 200 space not out space. Now is alpha Sachin Tendulkar 200 not out, Sachin Tendulkar not out. It has got math here, 200 here. This has got no math here and no space here. So this should alone be true, and you can see that first two are return false. Right? Fun. Finally, all in one here, I'm going to just follow everything in one. Is digit. This will help you in understanding if everything is a digit. Sachin Tendulkar 200 not out. Is it a digit? No. We have got a lot of characters inside. 200. Is it a digit? Yes. So false, true. I got it right. Now is lower. Is lower is a function that is used to tell true if there is at least one character and everything is lowercase. Sachin Tendulkar 200 not out. There are a lot of uppercase letters. 200, math, Shriram, all lowercase. So the last one alone should be true. Can we see that? False, false, true. Yes, we have got the output. Is upper, similarly, I need to have all characters. At least one character must be there and everything should be uppercase. This is not all characters. This is math, all uppercase letters. So the third one should be true. Right? And finally, length. It will give you the length of the string. So it is 24. Very simple. I hope you enjoyed this session, and this is all fun. Try it out in your machine, folks. All these codes and all will be uploaded shortly. I'm just trying to create a repository for a long time, which is a pending activity from my end. I'll do it shortly. If you have any comments, suggestions, inputs, please go ahead and type it in the comment section. I'll be more than happy to answer that. Thank you very much for the tremendous support that you guys have been giving over years. Thank you very much.